All right, everyone, welcome to another video here with Invest for Tomorrow. And to all the first time viewers and investors, welcome to the channel. And to all the subscribers, welcome back, guys. In this video, I'm going to just discuss a few topics here because it's very interesting what I'm seeing going on, not just on the YouTube platform, but just overall in different, you know, forums, you know, on StockTwits, all the different comments that I'm seeing, and it's just all adding up. And a lot of investors are in frustration, confusion, and not understanding what's going on. So I don't know if you guys have been around since then, and if you're a first-time viewer, you can probably find these videos back in February. But back in February, I started to see, right, the beginning of a correction. And throughout this whole entire correction, basically on the second jump here and slight pullback, I started to say, guys, I believe we're in the midst of a correction or crash. You want to start watching this. And certainly it went from 3,800 down to lows here of 37 and from the highs here of 39. So it was like almost a 200 point drop. And then I also told everyone, you know, the difference between a crash and a correction. There's several different point differences. So if it's 200 to 500, you know, it could sometimes be close to a crash. And usually the best way to actually go ahead and calculate that is by the 10% point of the highest point of the total amount. So 3,900, anything beyond, you know, 3,900 is close to a crash because that 200 to 500 range of points falls into crash category. Anything below that 390 is in that 5 to 10% range, and that could be a correction. So we were in the midst of a correction. It could turn into a crash, I always said. But then as soon as the correction was reversing, we saw that spike pretty strong right there in that one time, right? And then we saw it happen here again. We're seeing a strong spike. Now we want to see if this strong spike can hold. And you know what's interesting? I believe this was March 5th right here to the March 8th. And March 5th, when that big correction happened, it was a Friday, guys. Pretty interesting. March 5th was a Friday, and now we see this big spike here. If you see the correlation, May 14th is a Friday as well. So we're going to see if things repeat themselves. And if they do, I'm not saying we're going to have a big bull run like this one, but if this little correction already is in the past, this could start to push upwards to newer highs and new resistance levels. But the thing of this whole entire video, like I started saying, I'm seeing in the comments and I'm seeing everywhere on StockTwits and stuff, is a lot of investors are a little frustrated, okay, and confused. And I completely understand where they're coming from, especially if the investors have not been in the market for more than 2 years, right? I remember when I went through it in 2018, and it leads to confusion and frustration because whatever you got used to doing in the past, right, if you've only been in the market since 2020 till present, right after that crash, yeah, you rode the whole entire bull run from this crash and it looked pretty easy and it was pretty fun. But I've been saying in all my videos since the beginning of this correction, and I've always said it in this correction, every setback is a setup for the next bull run, right? And every pullback is the beginning of the next bull run. And the bull run does not start at the drop here. If not, it starts at the peak of the drop and the bull run is forming before it even comes, right? So that pullback is the anticipatory outlook of what could come. And there you go. Every single pullback is the beginning of the next bull run. I've been saying it all year, and I've also stated that every setback is a setup and you have to go ahead and find the opportunities. You have to actually understand what's going on. And I've stated to everyone, whatever you got used to in 2020 is no longer going to work. Then a lot of things too that have happened is a lot of individual investors' portfolios, while the S&P 500 is going higher, their portfolios are going lower, right? The reason why that's happening is because of the transition. I pointed out many different ticker symbols that are moving along with this in the same direct correlation and looking pretty similar. I've pointed it out. I've shared it with you guys back here when we started to see this run and I started to bring some clarity to investors. But the whole issue here is if you're not changing your strategy, there's two things that are happening. If you were already losing money on the way up here, if you got in at some point around here and your positions have not gone up by much, or they did and they started to fall really fast and you haven't made money as it's going up, then you're losing more money if you're holding, right? Just an example. Now, the other one is, which is another example, is investors that made money in 2020 are now giving back their money to the market, basically breaking even or now at a loss. And that's where the confusion and frustration comes into play, because investing is not really a short-term outlook. It's supposed to be a long-term outlook. When I zoom in here, you can see where the S&P 500 once was, right? Almost one-fourth of where it's at now, back in 2011, okay? It took 10 years for that to 4X, okay? Investors are looking for stocks to 4X like they did in 2020 in just a few months. That doesn't happen every day. That doesn't happen all the time. And 2020 was one of those times where the stock market was rallying because of the support of the Fed. And it was one of the rare cases where a lot of growth and innovative sectors were growing pretty fast because of the shutdown stocks, and then the cyclical and the value stocks were being beaten down because their businesses were low on business or even shut down for most parts of the country or world. So yes, this was all a one-time thing, and not saying that you can't see bull runs like this again and that growth stocks will move like that again sometime in the future. But when you're investing, you have to invest with an outlook into the future, not just a few months from now. If you're looking for instant gratification, you are not going to receive that very quickly from the stock market overall. Now, if you're swing trading and day trading, which is a little bit much more difficult, which we do over at the Discord every single day, we're looking for opportunities for 5 to 10%, 10 to 20%, you know, and hitting that consistently as much as possible, then you may find some opportunities. But at the end of the day, overall, the market is a long-term vehicle. It's not a vehicle that's going to get you from point A to point B really fast and that your account is just going to multiply. Now, the growth sector and innovative stocks have been hit pretty hard, as well as tech, because of all the uncertainty with tapering, inflation, bond yields going up, and all that fun stuff has been affecting overall the market. Okay, I get that. But at the end of the day, those were the strategies from 2020. And if you think about it, all the stocks that were down in 2020 are up this year. Try to do some research on that. And all the stocks that were up in 2020 are down this year. So that's why the strategy changes. And the strategy is ever changing. You can't stick to the same plan every single year. You just can't. Unless you have a stock that you're not worried about where it goes every year to year, because you're looking at the 5-year, 10-year plan to 2X, 3X, that's different. And that's real investing. But investors that have came in a very great time or bull run per se of 2020 to this year have actually now ended up in a state of confusion or frustration, because it was pretty interesting to see stocks move up how they did. I've never seen that before, how they did last year to this year. And a lot of investors have thought to think they got this. And if you haven't been doing technical analysis, and if you haven't trying to learn your charts, you are in a state where the charts are going to deceive you, the market's going to deceive you, and you're not going to understand what is going on, guys. So it's so important to understand charts. It's so important to understand that right now in this pullback, you know, we want to see if things start to pull up again or consolidate. But to me, it's looking like after this bull run that's happened, we may be in a sideways movement until there's a catalyst pushing it up, or if not, into inflation getting higher. If it's not priced in, it's going to start to pull us down again, and the overall market is going to suffer and things are going to be very turbulent for the next several months. After these months pass, then hopefully inflation starts to go ahead and turn transitory. There has to be that confirmation that interest rates don't have to rise so soon, and the tapering is going to start happening sometime in the near future after that, something like that. Then we may start to see the stocks run back up, and some of the most beaten down stocks, if the transition goes back into growth and tech, which is not guaranteed. That's something to watch, that's something to see. But at the end of the day, if you're investing in growth and tech, you're not supposed to be investing for those instant gains that we saw last year to this year. You're supposed to be investing years out and with the outlook of that company growing, right? Because if the company is not profitable, you can't see your stock go higher. The reason why stocks were going higher is because, yes, a lot of investors were jumping into these stocks, and a lot of hedge funds and institutional investors. But at the end of the day, what makes stocks go up is their earnings and the revenue and net profit, guys. It's so important to be aware of that, because a growth of a company is the growth of its stock. Just keep that in mind. Now, some people can argue, well, what if the company is growing, but it's not actually reflecting in the stock? Well, then that has to do with the net profit at the end of the day, with the balance sheet and the financials overall and the earnings per share and all that other more detailed stuff. So that's something that's a little bit more in depth, but that's just to kind of answer those questions. If you guys learned something new, don't forget to subscribe. And if you want to know what stocks I watch daily and weekly, you can join us over at the Patreon and Discord. The link is down below in the description. And thank you guys so much for watching, and let's make some money.